Let us now have a look at the structures of the functional groups we are going to study, you know, in our chapter. So, since we are in the chapter alcohols, phenols and ethers, we will be studying three functional groups, one for, you know, methanol, which is an alcohol, then for an ether and then for a phenol. So, friends, we know, you know, what how methanol looks like, CH3OH, right? OH is a functional group over here. The bond length between carbon and oxygen is 142 pm, whereas between OH is 96 pm. These are factual details. Carbon is bonded to oxygen through a sigma bond, and both have, you know, the sp2 hybridized orbital of both carbon and oxygen overlap each other. This bond angle COH is 108.9 degrees. Do you see, you know, any, do you have any doubt here? Alcohols have a tetrahedral shape, right? And do you know what it is? It is 109.28 degrees. Then why would alcohol have a lesser bond angle? Well, the reason is that these two unshared pair of electrons, these are the same charges, right? So, these repel this bond this side, and this one repels this bond this side. So, this repulsion makes this bond angle smaller in methanol than the tetrahedral angle. Right? This is one important thing to notice about methanol or alcohols. Repulsion between unshared pair of electrons makes ROH angle lesser than the tetrahedral angle. I come to ethers now. The bond length of ethers is 141 pm. COC bond angle is a bit larger than the alcohols. It's 111.7, right? And that's about it. And the bond length is almost same as alcohols. Alcohols at 142 pm. Ethers is 141 pm. And why would bond angle be more? Well, it is because these two bulky alkyl groups, now, you know, these are both having a delta positive charge because of this oxygen. So, they repel each other, right? Two similar charges repel each other, making this bond angle larger. In alcohols, this side there was hydrogen. So, not much, you know, polarity on this OH, and there was not much repulsion between C and H, right? So, repulsion between two R groups is what makes bond angle of ethers larger than that of alcohols. We come to phenols now. The bond length between C and O is 136 pm. As we can see, it is lesser than that of alcohols, right? And bond angle is 109 degrees, which is fine, almost similar. So, reason for, you know, this smaller bond length is the resonance structure, right? You know, you will see later in the slides that the bond over here gets broken and there is a negative charge at this position, then there is a, you know, bond, double bond at this position, and hence electrons keep on rotating on the ring, which gives this a double bond character, right? And double bonds are always shorter than the single bonds, and hence, you know, this slightly double bond resonance kind of characters makes bond length of phenols smaller, right? Alright, which of the following has highest bond length? What is the answer?